At some point, the floodgates will open. We'll leave our homes, get back on the streets, back to work, back to something that looks like normal. Or will we?
I think for me, I want us to get through this as best we can, and then on the other side, try and make ourselves whole.
State Senator Ramesh Akberry.
Now, what that whole looks like, it might be a little different than what we expect.
In fact, the whole could be a whole lot different. Listen to COVID-19 Task Force member Dr. Jeffrey Warren.
And those people who've had it need to have, you know, like a vaccination card.
Something like a COVID card.
And then those are the ones that we can put back out to work and get them back, you know, waiting our tables without a mask.
A certificate that proves you're disease-free.
I personally, if you're coming in serving me food, you know, I'd like to know that, you know, if you don't have your mask on, that you've had the virus and you're good. You could show me that if I wanted to know.
I think that we definitely need to think about something like that, maybe more so a little more high-tech, something on our phones, something that they've done in China, because it can update automatically.
We have a lot of rules like that. You know, you have a passport to allow you to get on a plane to fly out of the country. You have to apply for that. You have to pass certain criteria. Then you get your passport.
Speaking of passports, some states have used border checkpoints in the crisis to identify people who might be infected. With Tennessee bordering 8 other states, the senator wouldn't be opposed to it.
I think so, to stop the spread. I know in Florida, they were specifically stopping people from Louisiana and New York. So I do think that that could be a possibility.
But some are ready to tap the brakes.
We'll be fighting over here before that happens. That is just absolutely outrageous. That's a violation of all our civil rights.
Terry Rowland is a former Shelby County Commissioner.
We're living through some trying times, something that none of us live and probably have experienced. But we don't want our civil liberties to fade away in the middle of this.
And obviously we have privacy concerns. We are not a communist nation. We are a democratic nation, a republic. So I think that that's obviously something we'll have to balance.
I don't think it's got anything to do with us being a free society as much as it does with us being a smart society and trying to protect each other.
Debate that is just now beginning. One thing is certain, though, we will be seeing changes for restaurants, for movie theaters, sporting events, and for concerts. And it is looking more and more like social distancing will not just be new to the lexicon, but part of our new way of life.